function to financial management. So the function, scope, and goals of financial management. So for the functions, we have estimation of capital requirements, choices of sources of funds, the investment of funds, the management of cash, the disposal of surplus, and the financial controls. And then the scope of financial management, we have liquidating decision. So it's about the decision of the working capital of the entity. The next is the investment decision, which decision for the investment in fixed assets. Then financing decision, the decision on how to acquire or the finance from the long-term sources. Then the dividend decision, which is the net profit distribution to shareholders. Then the goals of financial management is for the survival, how to beat the competition, how to maximize the sales, to minimize the cost, and to maximize the profits. But the important goal of financial management is the shareholder wealth maximization, which pertains to the market price of the share. Then the last would be the task of financial manager, which are the forecasting and planning, the investment and financing decision, coordination and control, the transaction in the financial market, and how to manage the risk.
There are different methods in analyzing financial statements. Two of them are vertical analysis and horizontal analysis. Vertical analysis is a method showing items within a statement as a percentage of a risk figure within the statement, while horizontal analysis is a method that shows the changes in the base figure or the base period over a period of time as an amount or in percentages. We'll have more of financial statement analysis after a short break.
So hi guys! I'm looking for my group mates for our mass activity. What's wrong with you? No, no. Oh, so there they are. Asa to sila? Wait, dara. This is a masalot. Dara, oh, dara.
Welcome back to our lecture video. Now let's
talk
about financial ratios. In financial ratio, you must know what is being measured in order for you to construct your ratio and to understand the resulting number. There are five categories of financial ratios that are used in financial statement analysis. First is the liquidity ratio that shows the ability of the firm to pay off its currently maturing obligations, like the current ratio and equity ratio. The second category is the asset management ratio that shows how efficiently the firm is using its assets, like the inventory turnover ratio, day sales outstanding, and the asset turnover ratio. The third category is the debt management ratio that shows the ability of the firm to pay off its long-term debts as well as how it finances its assets. Ratios such as debt-to-asset ratio and bank's interest earned ratio belong to this category. The fourth ratio is the profitability ratio that shows how profitably the firm is operating and utilizing its assets, just like the profit margin ratio, return on asset ratio, basic earning power, and the return on equity ratio. Last but not the least is the market value ratio that gives us an idea of what investors think about the firm. Ratios such as price to earnings ratio and the market to book ratio belongs to this category.
So, another method in financial statement analysis is the cash flow analysis. First, let's talk about what is statement of cash flows. When we say statement of cash flows, it shows the details of cash inflows and cash outflows. It involves three sections: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. When we say operating activities, it relates to transactions in current assets and current liabilities. For example, generation of funds in normal operations. And the second section is the investing activities. It relates to transactions in non-current assets, for example, sale of property, plant, and equipment. And the third section, or the last section, is financing activities. It relates to transactions in non-current liabilities and shareholders' equity, for example, sale of bonds. After each section is completed, the results are added together in order to arrive at the net increase or decrease of cash. So let's go to the free cash flow concept. Free cash flow, it is the byproduct of the statement of cash flows. Theoretically, free cash flows is the total amount of money that could be returned to its shareholders if no future growth is realized. The formula of free cash flow is cash flow from operating activities minus capital expenditures minus dividends. So let's go to the financial forecasting using AFN. If the result is positive, the entity needs more fund. If it's negative, the entity has enough resources of funds. So the formula of AFN, guys, is the increase in asset minus increase in spontaneous liabilities minus increase in retained earnings. That's all. Thank you.